In this video, let us understand how to calculate compound interest. So this is a Python program example to find compound interest. First, let us know what is compound interest. So what is compound interest? So if there is an amount, so if you take a loan, so particularly when you talk about the loan, there is a principal amount. Principal amount. For this amount, you have to pay the interest. Let's say for 1 year, if 1000 rupees is the principal at 10% for 1 year, so you have to pay 100 rupees interest. 100 rupees is the interest. In case if you are not paid, then what will happen? Your 1000 plus 100, it becomes a principal. For next month, your principal will, for next year, its principal will be 1100. Then what happen? So by next year end, your interest will be 110. That is the interest. Even if you don't pay this also, then 110 plus this your old principal, put together it becomes a new principal. So this is 1 to 10. So therefore this becomes 1 to 10. So therefore that is what you become a new principal. So likewise, so if you take a loan and if you are not paid the interest, your interest will be added to the principal, then that becomes a new principal. Likewise, every year your interest will be keep on adding to your principal. So therefore, end of the day, you need to pay huge amount of interest. That is the compound interest. Let's understand the compound interest. Now let's see that how to write the program for the same. So in the previous example where you found simple interest, so this we already used. So if you not yet watched the video, please watch the video for simple interest. So these three statements we already written to take the principal amount, rate and the duration. Now based on this only, so we'll read all these values from the user and now let us calculate the compound interest. To calculate the compound interest, the formula is, so here you can see amount that is equal to P bracket 1 plus R by N to the power of NT. If you talk about like yearly interest, then this N is 1. So this N becomes 1. R is the rate of interest. So what are the percentage of rate? If 10% means 10 by 100. Now let us convert this into formula in Python. So here is the formula. This is the amount. This is the principal multiplied by. So this is 1 plus R by 100. So R by 100, because R is the rate of interest. Therefore, what are the interest you take? That divided by 100. And n is 1, so therefore n is not there here, and then nt, t will be there here, and this to the power of t, therefore power up function we are using here. Now this amount is including the principal, so therefore if you want to only know the compound interest, so therefore you can say compound interest CI, so that is equal to amount minus principal. P is the principal. Let's print the CI. Okay, let me run this. We'll take 1000. So rate of interest is 10 for 10 years. So then you can see that 1593.74 is the total compound interest. Interest with compound interest. Let's format this. You can say that this compound interest is let me format this. Fine, we close the quotes here and then this format CI. Now let's run this. So principal amount, it's 1000. 10 rate of interest, 10 years. So you can get 1593 74. This is the compound interest. So what we'll do is, let's find out what is the simple interest. And the same input will do the job. Therefore, you can say SI is equal to, so that is PRT. So P into R into T, so divided by 100. Right. Now, we'll use the same statement. So simple interest. That is SI. Now let us run the program. So now it's 1000, 10%, 10 years. Now you can see that the total interest will be 1593.74 if it is a compound interest. If it is a simple interest, then it is a 1000. That means if you are not adding interest to the principal, you don't need to pay the extra interest. But whereas if you say it is a compound interest, you can see that the amount will be increases. If a small amount, okay. If it's a bigger amount, then you can see that huge amount you have to pay. So it's a 5 lakh, 10% interest for 20 years. So you can see that the simple interest will comes to 10 lakh. Right. So whereas this comes to 28 lakh. So 18 lakh extra you have to pay off. So it's a quite huge money, right? So that's how we can calculate the simple interest and the compound interest. So please practice this. Let me know what you think. Please write it in the comment box. And also please subscribe to our channel.